Salvage Hunter Drew is at Buccleuch Estate in Scotland.
It's cool looking, isn't it?
It's a nice thing.
He's awaiting the outcome of a phone call to the Duke.
I'm pretty nervy. I've been trying to get into this place for ages. It's taken a lot of work. I'm really, really keen to take some of this stuff home, so fingers crossed he comes back with good news.
Ah, Richard, what did he say?
We can't do the saddle racks.
All right, OK.
But we can do the plate racks.
The plate racks up, yeah. OK.
OK, so how much are these, Richard?
We're looking at about £75 each, so...
It's too much.
Too much?
Yeah, it's too much. £120 for the three.
£120 for the three?
That's it, yeah.
You can just push it that wee bit more. £130, the three?
Yeah, sure.
OK,
lovely. Nice. Excellent. OK, so we've bought some stuff, that's great. So what do you want for these?
Probably looking about £300 for those, I'd say.
Can you do a little bit better? Knock a little bit off, maybe?
Take it maybe £270.
Yeah, that's fine.
That do?
Yeah, I don't wanna beat you up at all on these. Yeah. These are great, I'm really happy with them. This one.
You know, somebody renovating a country house, you know, that's gonna look...
Yeah, definitely, it's got such a great look about it. Yeah. Really has. Nice one, lovely, thank you. Buying some stuff, excellent.
I think both myself and Drew are happy with the deals we have done today. I'm certainly happy, you know, and I think Drew's happy. I don't think I've made him pay more than he needed to.
It's a real privilege, and you've got my number.
I have.
Give me a call.
It's so good to get in here and to buy stuff, get a good connection, find something I can sell at a profit.
I've got somebody in mind for the plate racks, and I'm not going to have them long. So, yeah, really, really pleased.
They're on their way to Coventry to a narrowboat builder and restorer called Pete Gilbert. It's not the boats they're going to see, but his scrapyard that's been built up over three generations.
Wow. You have got the best place in the whole world.
Pete's place to me is just like heaven. I think I'm probably like one chromosome away from doing this, but I'm not far off. I could easily end up like this. You know, left to my own devices, this could happen.
It's from my great-granddad, my dad and me. We got old engines and stuff and bits and bobs.
It just gets better.
You see why I'm happy? Come on, up you go.
He's a handsome devil, isn't he?
That's it.
This takes me back to being a kid and rooting through junkyards. You just don't think places like this exist anymore.
My great-granddad, he built this place. He was a boatman.
The yard covers around an acre, so Drew's going to have his work cut out to see all that Pete has to offer.
I do need to spend 2 weeks here. I need to hire a canal boat and stay here for a couple of weeks. There's so much stuff. Every time I turn around, I'm trying to find something else. All I wanted when I was a kid was a scrapyard.
Well, I had one.
You've got one. I'm really enjoying my day here with Peter, but it really is now time to start buying.
Drew spots something he's seen before and dives straight in with a request.
This little chap here, who I'd really like a lot. I've owned one before. It sold very, very quickly, and it sold well. I was surprised to find that, and I definitely want to be taking that home with me.
This mid-century whippet is very collectible and can sell for around £200.
Nice, lovely. It's so out of context here where it is. Brought in somewhere else, that's really going to shine.
Obviously without the collar.
But is this something I could have a go at?
You've got to have a word with the wife about that. She's in charge of that one.
He has to talk to senior management and we'll see how we go.
He's worth a few quid to me, so...
She wants some money, so I'll try and tell her that's the only way to get it. Sell it to Drew.
Yeah, these are good.
They interested me when I seen them.
Fantastic. Good, aren't they? These are the enamel factory pendants.
That's it. Yeah.
And they're 1950s sort of factory lights, and I love them. We're always buying and selling them. Do you know the top section for these?
Not all of them, I don't think.
They were just built for an industrial purpose, but they translate very, very well into using them in residential and interior design projects.
They're always beaten up, but that's part of their charm, all the rust and everything on them.
We can restore them and have them rewired in-house a couple of days. The shape's great, it's stylish, and everybody wants these. They're things I can sell.
Industrial lamps are popular with interior designers, and once restored, coolicons like these can fetch around £175 each.
Well, if we said for the three large ones, £75?
Yeah, yeah, go on.
Sure?
Yeah, yeah, go on.
These three here, 30, £10 a piece.
Yeah.
That's a bit mean, 15. £15 a piece for those. That's, yeah, about, that's, yeah, well, that's fairer. So 45, 75.
Yeah.
Yeah? First purchase, money changing hands. Great. Always makes it a little bit easier for me. And it just relaxes everything and, you know, oils the wheels.
I think that we used as a heat lamp for the chickens.
Drew is always on the lookout for the unique, and he spots something that definitely fits the bill.
These are fantastic. They're either been made by somebody at an art college or something like that.
I think they're Roman.
There's something about them I like. Is that the top? That's like stoppers.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow.
Look at that. Really weird looking. No chips, nothing missing. They're great.
But once again, Peter's reluctant to strike a deal and defers to a higher authority.
Where are they from?
The missus is...
I can't find any marks or anything.
Somewhere. I'll phone her up and see what they're all about. Yeah. You know these pots you've got in that blue tub? What are they? You know, them odd-shaped things? Yeah, that's
weird
it.
Weird things.
These are for sale, then.
What about £80?
No, you
just charge her off. Yeah. Yeah, she'd be happy with that.
That's all right, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, yeah, keep her okay. happy.
OK, yeah, we'll take those.
With a couple of purchases under his belt, Drew is happy, but he's not ready to leave just yet.
It'd be worth trying her on the dog again, because the dog is worth £100 to me.
Yeah.
I'm really hoping we can buy that dog statue. That's the thing, it's sort of bothering me, because, like, I know I can sell it like that, really want it.
And just as they're off, Peter arrives with some good news.
Yeah, Drew, I've had a word with the missus and she said she'll let you have that.
Really?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
All right.
That's brilliant.
Yeah.
Thanks very much. Well,
yeah.
It's been a pleasure. It really has. I've enjoyed myself.
And me.
No end. A very good day.
All right then.
Fantastic.